Okay, let me tell you, I'm a simple guy, and I just want to have a simple life. But sometimes, WolframAlpha really wants to complexify my life, and this is what I mean. Check this out. We have this absolute value equation. We can solve it pretty easily. First, add 2 to both sides, and we get this. And then we can break this into two equations. 3x plus 1 equals negative 6, and the other one, 3x plus 1 equals 6. For the first equation, x equals negative 7 over 3. And for the second one, x equals 5 over 3. And then we are done, right? And truth to be told, at first, I didn't even want to solve this. All I wanted to do is to put this equation onto WolframAlpha. And this is what I did. But this is what I got. Oh my goodness. What does it give me? X is equal to negative 1/3. Plus 2 times e to the in power. What does this even mean? Well, I will tell you. This is just all the complex solutions to that absolute value equations. Yeah, so let's talk about how to solve it. Firstly though, I will rewrite the equation again, but I'm not going to be using x. Rather, I'll be using z because it looks like a complex number like this. And the usual way to do this is that we will isolate the absolute value part. And here we have this 3 in front of the z, right? Let's factor that out. So we get 3 times z plus 1/3. And then still add 2 to both sides. So we get this. And then divide the 3 to both sides. Yeah. So we will have absolute value of z plus 1/3 is equal to 2. Now, we can actually solve this conceptually. This is what I mean. Understand the absolute value. It means what? It means the distance, right? Between two things. But be careful though. Here we have z, right? And the other one, well, it's not 1/3, but rather negative 1/3. Because we have to look at this as z minus negative 1/3, right? That's how we find the difference. That's how we find the distance. And now we want the distance right here. It says it's equal to 2. Okay, so let's think about it. The distance between z, which is a complex number, and negative 1/3, which is the real number, is equal to 2. What are the possibilities? Well, the answer for that, it's a circle. And let me draw that for you. Let's say here is negative 1/3. And then the distance is just the radius of the circle. And let's just go ahead and put it down like this. Right? So the radius is 2. And that's it. This represents the set of all the complex solutions. Now, we are on the complex plane. So this is the real axis, and this is the imaginary axis. And in fact, we actually have the real solutions from here as well. They are on the real axis. Take a look. If we start with negative 1/3 and go to the right 2 units, so just add 2 to it, we will end up with 5 over 3. And if you go from negative 1/3 to the left 2 units, here we will end up with negative 7 over 3. And they are both real numbers. All right, let's talk about how the WolframAlpha get this answer. It's actually not so bad. We can actually go from here to here. Z equals. Once we know it's a circle, we can just do the following. Check this out. First, let's write down the center, which is the real number negative 1/3. And then we are going to add the radius of the circle, which is the 2. And then we have to multiply it by e to the I. I really have no idea why WolframAlpha used n, because n is usually for integers. So let's use theta. It's much better in my opinion. This actually represents the circle I just drew for you guys. And of course, we will have to talk about what does the part that says e to the I theta mean. It's actually just from the Euler's formula that represents cosine theta plus I times sine theta. And in fact, if you look at this as the x part and look at this as the y part, in fact, you'll realize we are just talking about the unit circle on the complex plane. So let me break this formula down for you guys. We start with the unit circle from the e to the I theta part. And then we multiply this by 2. So that means we take the unit circle, you know, just make it bigger. The radius is 2 now, all right? And then we add negative 1/3 to it. All it does is just move the circle. What? 3 times 1, well, negative 1, well, move the circle 1/3 times to the left. And that's how we cut this right here, all right? So I think that's pretty cool. But sometimes you don't get circles all the time. So let me show you guys a more systematic way to do it. So check this out. Instead of doing all that, we can also do this. We can write z as the standard form of the unit circle. But instead of writing down as a plus bi, we can put down x plus yi. And x and y are real numbers here. Keep that in mind. Perhaps I'll write that down as well. All right. We can put this into this z right here. So we will have the following equation. Absolute value of x plus yi plus 1/3 is equal to 2. Now let's just kind of take care of this a little bit. I'm going to put the x and 1/3 together because they are both real numbers. And then we have yi that has the complex part, right? The imaginary I. Now, absolute value still means the distance. What does it mean though when we have a complex number inside? Well, have a look. Here's a note. When we have the absolute value of a complex number, let's say a plus bi, let's have a look. Let's say here's a plus bi. Well, we want the distance from the origin to the complex number. Well, that's just the hypotenuse, right? And you know this right here is a, this right here is b. So you can use the Pythagorean theorem. That's the square root of a squared plus b squared. So we can take off the absolute value here by just putting down the square root and then square the real part and add it with the y part here. And let me put down here 1/3 and then y, and that's equal to 2. And now to get rid of the big square root, let's just square both sides. And ladies and gentlemen, we can see that's x plus 1/3 squared plus y squared, that's equal to 4. So we end up with the equation that we can recognize rather easily, because now we can see that this is just going to give us a circle. And whenever you have a circle, you should tell the center. The center is what? You see 1/3, but it's actually negative 1/3. Remember, it's x minus h, right? So negative 1/3 here. And then this is just y squared, so it's 0. And the radius is a square root of this number, which is just a 2. And this is exactly what we have right here. All right, so that's pretty much it. At the end of the day, though, I will tell you, sometimes it might be just easier if you do things by hand to keep your life simple. That's it.